Hey guys, welcome back to We Watch a Movie. Mike here, talking about John Wick. I just got to see this early for once. Living in Kentucky, we never get to see these damn movies early, but I got to see John Wick, starring Keanu Reeves. It's directed by a couple of his stuntmen, or at least one of his stuntmen. I'm not sure if they both were or not, but one of the guys that was Keanu Reeves' stuntman actually directed this movie. It's their first feature. It's two guys, and you could tell it's directed by a stuntman, and I mean that in a good way, because this movie is badass. It's gun porn, it's what it is, and in a good way. It's Keanu Reeves, who's back, who was gone, it seemed like, for forever. You gotta love Keanu Reeves. Whoa. It's a hitman in this movie who retires to be with the girl that he loves. She ends up dying, and she leaves this one gift for him, which is a dog. And it's this cute little puppy dog, and everybody in the theater oohs and ahs when they see the dog. He runs into Theon Greyjoy from freaking Game of Thrones. He's this Russian mobster son who thinks he's a badass, and he's like, I like your car. John Wick won't sell him his freaking car. So they break into his house, not knowing that he's this badass ex-hitman, kill his dog, and steal his car. So then Keanu Reeves goes on a vengeance-fueled rampage to kill everyone. Simple as shit, really. But it is awesome the way they do it. I like that they kept it simple. For one, I think I understand why they're showing these pre-screenings of this movie to people. And I think it's because it's an R-rated action film, which we don't get any of now, because it seems like every time they do get one, Judge Dredd or Dredd, it's like it's poorly promoted, something goes wrong, and for one reason or another, there's no high ticket sales for it. So nobody wants to do R-rated action movies, which is why we got that shitty PG-13 Expendables 3 version. So they figure, you know what, this movie's badass, we know we have a good movie in the can here, and we're going to show it to people, let's try to get some word of mouth going. Good call on their part. I really hope this works out, because I want more R-rated action movies. And this is, it does not hold anything back. This is what RoboCop should have been, even though it has nothing to do with one another. And RoboCop, you had these cutaways, and it just wasn't RoboCop. It wasn't, because it was PG-13 and a whole list of other reasons. But in this, someone gets shot in the face from this far away, and you see the whole thing. It's not nasty to be nasty, there's no over-the-top gore whatsoever in it. It's just a badass action movie that knows it's a badass action movie. And it looks like a fucking David Fincher movie. Maybe that's taking it a little bit too far, saying it looks like a David Fincher movie, but the cinematography is absolutely badass in this movie. It's that bluish, sleek, just stylish look. And I haven't seen an action movie that looks this stylish in a really long time. But it has the balls to it, too. I mean, everybody knows what a badass John Wick is. So when they find out he's coming for him, they're like, oh, shit. A lot of times in these movies, the old-time Steven Seagal-type movies, where they go after, they're so badass, it's like, there's no good bad guys that can really fight him. But John Wick's been out of the game for a little while, so he's a little bit rusty, so almost everybody he comes up to is a little bit of a challenge for him. And they film the stunts and the fights excellently. There's no shaky cam bullshit, there's none of that stuff. All the fights look awesome. And my favorite part about this movie is when he starts to use the gun. It's not just the simple point-and-shoot thing. Dude's doing, like, karate with the gun, and not over the top like it's too much, like it's just like it's not the transporter, you know what I'm saying? Just doing crazy shit with pistols, shooting people left and right all over the freaking place, and you're like, John Wick is truly a badass. And then you get a good fist hand-to-hand fight scene. All the stuff that you love, that you go to see an R-rated action movie for, is in this movie. Keanu Reeves does a great job acting. The bad guys are actually the main bad guy, who's the Russian head mobster. He can even fight a little bit in the movie. And the villains are even kind of likable somewhat. Not Theon Greyjoy, which I should know that guy's real name, but I don't. But his dad, who's the Russian main mobster, is actually a really likable guy. Like, he's funny. Like, there's one point in the movie where he calls somebody and he's like, you know, why did you do this? And they're like, because it's John Wick that's coming after you. And he's like, oh. And he's drunk the whole movie. And just, the bad guys are funny. The bad guys are kind of likable, but not to the point that you're not, you know, not to the point that you don't want to see John Wick kill him, because you do. Willem Dafoe was in it for just a little bit. He had a really small role, but he was badass in the role that he was in. So he wasn't on screen much, but when he was, it was really effective. Only bad thing I'll say about this entire movie is that it's so badass and you're watching it, and the first part's funny. Like, you really like Keanu Reeves' character. You like this John Wick guy. And they do this whole inner, I won't give anything away, but they have this whole, like, inner society of hitmen. And the way that they play that out is really cool, and that's all I'll say about that. The only bad thing I could possibly say about John Wick is that it's so fun in the first two acts that by the time you get to the third act, it's just, it doesn't have the same pizzazz as the first half of the movie did. You know, it's not as exciting, and kind of it wanes off just a little bit, but not much at all. Still enough for me to give this movie a 9 out of 10. It's the best action movie I've seen in years. It's just badass. There's nothing crazy, political, none of this shit about it. It's just a good, flat-out action movie that knows what it is and just takes being an action movie and does it seamlessly. It's stylish, it looks badass, the characters are cool, the fighting is awesome, and it's just a badass movie. John Wick, it's a 9 out of 10, it's super badass. And guys, What is your favorite Keanu Reeves performance movie of all time? What's your favorite Keanu Reeves movie of all time? And please, if I'm gonna say this, guys, go see this movie. We need this movie to do well so that we can get more movies like it. Go see this movie. I 100% vouch for this movie. You definitely need to get out, pay the money for the tickets to go see it. You will not be disappointed. This I promise you. Until next time, guys, I'm Mike. We watched a movie. We'll see you guys.
We watched a movie. Yeah. We watched a movie.